As of last night, the official canvassing, I believe that for Maguindanao, yung yes vote, 599,581, yung no vote, 9,000. Yung Basilan, yes vote, 147,598, yung no vote, 6,486. Cotabato City, yung yes vote is 36,682, ang no vote, 24,994. Ang wala, overwhelming, ang wala lang dito na overwhelming din yung Lanao Sur. I think, yung Sulu, etalo tayo dyan eh. Kaya huli ko na yung babanggit yun. Yung Lanao Sur, hindi mo linagay dito. Mali yung maro ko.
Sa February pa yung Lanao?
Hindi, Lanao North yun. Lanao Sur, overwhelming din. I think only 9,000 yata out of 500,000+ almost 500, over 500,000 is yes. Natalo lang tayo sa dalawang lugar. Unfortunately, we lost in the province of Sulu, but not overwhelmingly. If you look at the numbers, 163,000 voted no. The yes is 137,000, although we lost by about 20,000 votes. But you can see about 45% of the population really wanted to join us. The other 55% rather, I believe, unfortunately, were swayed by political...
In Sulu, you mean?
In Sulu. Were swayed by political influence by their leaders who did not want this in the first place. Those who filed the cases with the Supreme Court, the Tan family. Tan family of Sakurtan. In Isabela, we lost by a small margin of 3,000 votes. If I'm not mistaken, 22,000 yung no, 19,000 yung yes. So it was by a slim margin. And it's sad. It saddens me to say this kasi ma-isolate sila. Nasa gitna po sila ng barm. Tapos hahabol ka pa ng projects, pupunta ka pa ng Region 9 para lang mahabol mo yung projects. And you know, sayang because there's an opportunity to really develop the Barm or the Bangsamoro areas with this new law. So, overwhelming ang yes. I would say a total of less than 9% lang ang no for the total number of voters.
How would you interpret the results of Isabela? You interpreted the results of Sulu. How would you interpret the results of Isabela?
Well, napolitika din kasi yung Isabela. The mayor of Isabela is not allied with the governor and the Hatamans. And obviously, the same thing happened in Cotabato City. The incumbent mayor, who's a friend of mine, was not allied with the Sema family. So parang naging proxy war.
Okay.
Now, if you vote yes for BOL, that's like a vote for Sema. If you vote no for BOL, that's like a vote for Gianni. But it shouldn't have been that way. We should have looked at political future. Dapat ang pinag-isipan natin ang kinabukasan ng isang area at ng ating mga kababayan doon. Hindi politika. And unfortunately, that's how I feel it happened in Sulu. You know, galit si Governor Sakurtan sa ARM. And so he decided to forego any future developments with the Bangsamoro Organic Law or the BARM, B-A-R-M-M, because of politics also as well. So I'm worried, but I'm hopeful that they will accept the results of the outcome. Kasi no choice na rin siya, overwhelming yung yes. So I'm hoping and appealing to him to accept the results of the outcome of the Bangsamoro Organic Law. And let's move forward.